I'm curious about the pool of molten steel that was found in the bottom of the towers.
I am too.
And
please tell me about it. Have you seen it?
Well, not personally, but eyewitnesses there found huge poles of molten steel beneath the towers, and some scientists don't think that the collapse of the building could have melted all that steel.
First of all, let's go back to your basic premise that there was a pool of molten steel. I know of absolutely nobody, and no eyewitness who said so, nobody who's produced it. I was on the site, I was on the steel yards, so I don't know that that's so.
You'd get down below and you'd see molten steel. Molten steel running down the channel rails. Like you're in a foundry.
Like lava.
From a volcano.
Underground, it was still so hot that molten metal dripped down the sides of a wall from Building 6.
However, they do hit hot spots occasionally, and everything stops.
There were fires of 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit below the ground.
I don't know that that's so.
There's video of it.
It melted around 2,600 degrees Fahrenheit. I think it's probably pretty difficult to get that kind of temperatures in a fire.
Well, NASA pictures, thermal images showed those sorts of temperatures in the basement.
Would you send them to me?
Okay.
My name is Mark, and I'm the individual who was questioning Dr. Gross, and he asked me to email to him those thermal images. When I approached him after his talk to get his email address for that purpose, he refused to provide it to me. I think this is important because it reveals the attitude of the NIST investigators, which is one of willful ignorance of what really happened on 9/11.